Hi everybody, this is Fox Nomad and today I'm here at Edmonton. Yeah. Yeah. Been to Comic-Con in Sofia, Bulgaria. I've never been to a Comic-Con before. This is my first one. I've been to plenty of Star Trek conventions, so I wanted to go in and take a look and show you as well.
I used the base and I expanded its functionality. The lightsaber is made by myself, although it's not quite accurate, it serves the purpose to have a junk lightsaber.
Because I'm a fashion designer. By Harley, my mother read the comics, and father, they loved comics, DC especially. And then I saw her in a video game, and that was my first video game, the Batman Arkham City. And then I saw her with my first earned money when I start to work. I leave it something, I think it's cost 50 euros or something, 10 years ago. Harley, because she's
Yeah, LARP. So,
okay. Not particularly cosplaying anything.
Yeah,
I can.
I'm a Trekkie, but I know a little bit about Star Wars.
It's, you know, a lot of us go both ways. It's okay.
И да работя по това, което наистина ми допадаше много.
Yes. And after the face change, I got a lot of mail from fans going, "No, you have to come back. Why did you change your face? I can't believe it. Aya needs you." Yada yada yada. And then after I came back in season, the same fans, or maybe it was different ones, but a lot of fans. How dare you? I hate you.
That is the game. You have two phases. First you summon your creatures, and you are the first player, so you can start summoning your creatures. Then you summon your creatures, and then you go to fight.
Can I set this up like this here?
I've always considered myself like a cartoonist. I've always loved doing comics. Since I was a kid in school, I used to just draw all the time in school. And so I even though I worked in graphic design and art direction for about 10 years, I always would do little cartoons just for fun on the side. And then eventually I realized I didn't have to be in newspapers or magazines. I could just go online and just share whatever I felt like sharing. So I just started making random stuff. It would be about daily life, it'd be animals, space, just really anything that came to mind. In addition to that, I also had my ongoing thing with the Yeti that was just, for me, it was a fun character and it was kind of a projection of myself. And then I started getting attention online, and it was, people liked it, so then I was like, okay, I'm definitely going to keep going with this. And so it just kind of organically grew into adding the brain to Lars's dialogue to make it a little bit more in-depth. And then I added the heart to bring that emotional balance to decision-making, and that's when things really took off for me. That's when I knew I was going to be doing this forever. you know, I had hundreds of thousands of fans on, you know, Facebook, and I was able to quit my job a couple of years ago, and this is all I do now, and Heart and Brain are the stars of the show. I could have done it, but I was very afraid, and I wanted to be absolutely sure that I could handle it, so I went back and forth thinking about this for months, and it was good inspiration for the comics, though, because it was a lot of Heart and Brain tug of war. Like, Brain says, you have a job, it's a steady job, you get a paycheck, and Heart says, you know, live your dreams. So it really was living the comic, and I think that's what, like, having that real thing behind the comics made the comics that much more real and authentic, and people see that. They know when it's authentic versus when I just put a comic out that, you know, maybe is inspired by somebody else. But when it's, like, really a deep inspiration like that, it just, the comic, I think, really took off around that time, and it was perfect timing, and I got my publishing deal around that time, and I had a contract with an online publisher that paid at the time, and so financially with the, you know, the merchandise, everything was taking off, like, all at the right time, and then it all worked out, and quit the job, and I would never look back. It was the best decision of my life. Going to a coffee shop to write my comics when I didn't have to report to a job was one of the best days of my life. It was just sitting at a coffee shop, and, like, you probably had the same kind of experience with when you first...
Yeah, I did, actually. I did, yeah. Like, if I didn't do it, I'd be in an office right now.
Yeah.
It's pretty crazy.
And you'd make money and you'd be fine, but yeah, it wouldn't be what you needed in your life.
And now I'm here talking to you, which is, like, awesome.
I wrote a comic at one point, and it was with the Yeti, Lars, and it was about this ambition, and I sort of took everything in motivational memes and posters I had ever seen and what I was experiencing at the time, and I made this comic, and I didn't even intend on sharing it. It was like my own, like, you can do this, like, do it for you, and it's real, and don't worry about the money, like, do it for the right reasons. And then I shared that comic, and that really inspired a lot of people, and so I was really glad I shared it. But it's funny that, like, the things that are the most deeply true to me, I have trouble sharing. I don't, because it's so emotionally, I'm so emotionally invested in it. But then it's always a good payoff, because people end up relating to it, and they can use that in their own lives, so. And before the comics, I just dabbled in online t-shirt contests. They used to do these contests where you submit a design, and if you win, they give you some money. And I think that was one of the things that made me realize, like, oh, I might be able to do something online that could eventually lead to this. And yeah, I kind of left that part out earlier. It's kind of an important factor, but yeah, I was winning a lot of these contests. And, I think that's just what made me realize that there was potential. Before that, I don't know, I didn't think anybody made money on comics online.
Yeah, baby!